started or something.
What'd you say?
Having started restarting your computer.
Yeah, bro, you over there playing, bro. Hey, silly guy, you borged out. You gotta ask that question again, man.
No, sure. Playing, I mean.
Yeah, so my question was, do you think the fact that you were victimized so early on, do you think it's contributed to your obsession with fighting now? Because you're kind of trying to reclaim your your power.
You see what I'm saying?
No, that's a real valid point. Like, no, Jimmy, don't laugh that off. That's like a serious question.
That's not no valid point, bro. Like,
no, it is.
You're lagging out right now.
Nah, hold up. I think that in ninth grade, when I lost that fight,
Jimmy,
I lost that fight to that goddamn wrestler, bro.
Yeah, your mic keeps
fucking up. That's what made me obsessed with fighting.
Jimmy, no one can hear you. Your thing's just blanking, but there's no words coming out. You got to fix your mic.
It sounds like,
Now, fuck the, hey, shut the fuck up, bro. I know you motherfuckers is playing.
Doing it.
No one's playing, Jimmy. We came correct.
All right, so look, hold up. If I go check, I'm about to go check this shit right now.
You're boring out on our end.
And if it's good, I'm playing another track. Y'all motherfuckers is lying and playing games. I'm playing another track, bro.
Jimmy, it could be inconsistent space away from the microphone.
It might be.
Nah, it's not, bro. I think y'all motherfuckers is trying to play.
No, we're not playing, Jimmy.
Y'all are trying to interrupt the goddamn show, man. Let's hear it.
Shut up, faggot.
If we were interrupted, Jimmy, you know.
Tyler, you a bitch. Stop playing with me.
Shut up, retard, faggot, rape baby.
Jimmy, how does that make you feel?
They lie, bro. I'm playing another track. Bro, I earned another track. You motherfucker.
Jimmy, don't shoot yourself in the foot.
Now you got a
couple. Don't do it.
Get it all in the toilet.
Now you got a couple of minutes, and then we'll play another track since you want to play around.
Come on, Jimmy, you're a momentum killer.
What the fuck are you talking about? You lied about borging out, man. Fuck out of here.
I didn't lie about anything.
Jimmy,
I would like to get.
You good?
I would like an answer.
Yeah, you see what I'm saying? Hey, I mean, Jimmy, I fucking knew that. They trying to fucking play around. And
Jimmy,
shit.
Are you upset because you haven't eaten today yet? Are you hangry?
What are you talking about? I haven't eaten. I ate twice, bro. I had two chorizo tacos early this goddamn morning, and then I went to what is it? I went to the empanada spot. Hold up, I went to the empanada spot. And I got I got a sausage and a fucking potato.
No. Where do you get the money for that?
A whole goddamn potato. Yeah, but this is what I'm saying, bro. I fucked up and got a little bit too drunk. Like, my credit card bill ain't due till next week. Shut up, bitch.
So
my credit card bill ain't due till next week, so I got a little bit of money.
Keep on buying groceries on credit, you fucking retard.
Hey, nice try. Why are you trying to talk down on me eating box, bro? Fuck out of here.
Jimmy.
Because it was at the age of five.
That is fucked up. But I'm saying, those were some hoes.
Like no, but why are you trying to use it as a flex?
When I was five, when I was eight, them two chicks were some hoes, man.
Jimmy, you're the first person in general who I've ever heard brag about their rape experience.
Yeah, because, bro, I'm glad it was some goddamn hoes and not like a janitor.
See,
like,
this is why. So you're just claiming to be a sexual assault victim.
Yeah, bro, did you just hear what I said? I'm glad it was some hoes and not some janitor like y'all motherfuckers.
No, you just said you're glad it happened to you.
Nah, bro, I'm saying I'm glad it was some goddamn chicks, bro.
This guy is like pathetic white trash.
He really is.
You a bitch. Hey, bro. Tyler, you are a bitch.
Shut your bitch ass up.
Hey, yo, man, shut your bitch ass up.
Shut your bitch ass up.
You don't need to hit enough Cyraxx's cash app, you know? Dude, just admit it. You go live, they're fucking pummeled on.
That's a fucking lie, bro. I'm going live to see what the goddamn streets gotta say, bro.
I'm going live
to see what the streets gotta say, man.
YouTube's the internet. YouTube's not the streets. Hold up.
YouTube is the streets, man.
How?
What are you talking about?
You're in your kitchen at the table.
Y'all motherfuckers in your house. Y'all motherfuckers could slander a motherfucker the same way people do in the goddamn street, bro. Slander and
bury your mom under your AC unit.
Now, ain't nobody did none of that, bro. My mom is.
Why you kill your mom, Jimmy?
My mom is in the living room right now watching TV.
Then why hasn't she yelled at you to shut the fuck up yet?
Nah, bro, because man, I'm doing my thing.
Jimmy, did she hear you talking about you eating box at the age of five?
We're addressing the real comments. Look at this. Would Lord CP experience is actually something that does happen at an early age?
So why are you bragging?
Bro, I'm saying, bro, y'all grew up in different. Well, if y'all grew up in different goddamn environment.
Yeah, we grew up in an environment where never, we raped this kid.
I don't want to bring. I ain't gonna even bring that motherfucker.
Surprise.
Like that dude, because that would be a bad example.
Are you inferring that everyone around you and in the same environment as you got raped at the age of five?
Hold up, it's a couple of motherfuckers that I heard on YouTube be like, bro, I definitely did. It was definitely some older hoes that did some bullshit to me when I was a kid. It's more than a couple motherfuckers that can tell you that. I don't know if it's different. Like,
I've never met anybody y'all from different backgrounds. Or something. I don't know. Ever.
Well, yeah, we are from different backgrounds.
Y'all motherfuckers had to wait till later on in life to start experimenting with hoes.
I think that's the reason why she's not yelling at you right now is because you're probably holding a gun at her.
Tied up in the living room, gagged.
In the living room, gagged. Beaten. Nah,
but you motherfuckers are crazy.
That's why he's always walking around with a handgun. He's pistol whipping her.
Well, yeah, talk about that white boy.
Motherfuckers are crazy.
Talk about that white boy.
What's the statute of limitations in Texas?
Like, I don't know what it is.
Beaten.
Yeah, Jimmy, what were your stats at five?
Did you have that 6 foot wingspan?
Nah, bro, if I was like 225 something pounds. Not bad. If I was 225 pounds in middle school, I imagine that I was a hefty little young motherfucker. I think maybe. I saw some of my baby pictures, but I think maybe at 5 years old, I was probably, I would say maybe 50 pounds.
So, can you answer my question from earlier about, you know, you getting victimized early on contributing to your obsession with fighting now? Is it for like self-defense in case these hoes ever come back?
It's not because of a
janitor.
Let me tell you what my obsession with fighting is. I think it just feels good to know that like the majority of people who will try to test you can beat their ass, man. Like even with this shit, I know it might be a couple of motherfuckers that I fought in high school. That might want to like want to come online and talk some shit, bro. Like, I'm thinking about all this shit. If there's anybody that sees this shit from high school and I fought you, bro, we're going to have to do a round two, man. It's a couple of motherfuckers that I want to fight from high school again.
Jimmy, that's no reason to use your MMA training on your mom.
That's all it is. People want you to laugh at you. Why do you think these guys are up here? They're up here to fuck with you.
Shut the fuck up. We're talking about some... I don't give a fuck about what these motherfuckers are laughing at, bro. I'm thinking about the full scale, bro. I'm thinking about full scale. Hold up, what you motherfuckers did? It might be some op ass nigga from my real life that see this shit, and he be like, "Oh man, this motherfucker playing on YouTube and shit. Let me go in the chat room and try to fuck with him and shit." It's a couple of niggas from high school. I want to fight again, bro. Shut the fuck up.
Well, Jimmy, do you think if they stumbled across you on YouTube
in particular, bro?
Jimmy, do you think
I want to get that round two, bro. Especially
Jimmy, do you think if they came across your YouTube,
I'm trying to tell you why I want to fight now. The fuck,
Jimmy? History repeats itself. You're gonna get your ass kicked again.
Jimmy, do you think if your ops came across your YouTube and saw you got bullied by a bunch of white boys online, they would think you were a joke?
What do we call it? Ninth grade. Silly guy, don't say none of that. I think I just heard you say some bullshit. I didn't know how to get down in ninth grade, bro. Like when that motherfucker did that judo throw, that hip throw, whatever the fuck to me, man. And like he fell down in my goddamn, he took the mount. Like I didn't know about the fucking guard, bro. But I've been working on my goddamn guard game and shit, guard sweeps and stuff, bro. That dude was just like a.
So what do you like practice this like moves on or anything? Do you just like get into fights with strangers throughout the day and like you know?
Honestly, but let me speak on that. It was one dude I saw at the liquor store the other day. This dude was wearing a Gracie Barra hoodie. I was thinking about challenging that motherfucker to a wrestling match, bro. I want to see what that Gracie Barra is about.
So I mean, like you have been like you know practicing or anything? You just talk about it and like watch videos. That's
not bro, really I got hold up. I gotta go. I got a whole grappling dummy. I got a whole grappling dummy, and when I was going
to sex doll. Is it a sex doll?
I got a whole if you have this grappling dummy, why do you pay?
I got a grappling dummy, and when I was going to jujitsu and shit, I wasn't just going to jujitsu class, bro. I was going to the fundamental class, bro, the foundation class, man. What is it? It's sort of like drills or whatever the fuck, but it's basically like I went to basics class, bro.
So it's like nothing.
I'm not even trying to flex on my goddamn like my repertoire, whatever the fuck. But I got like a good, I got a good grasp of like
the basics. You were in like a grappling type camp, like these fucking kids, dude. We've seen the picture.
It wasn't no goddamn. Shut up, motherfucker! It wasn't no goddamn kids there like that, stupid.
We were Jimmy MMA day for like those
kids and old people. That's what it's meant for, not for you.
I was gonna say yeah. So you're in there like an able body young adult, just bullying little kids that are trying to learn how to defend themselves. So
if it was little kids there, why was it when y'all showed that picture? Why was it all those military age dudes there? I'm talking ages 21 to 35, whatever the fuck. Why was it all those military age dudes there? But y'all showed my MMA picture, bro. That was a whole.
Why don't you just say young? Why don't you just say young?
Class, bro. Fuck, debunked again. You got debunked again, bro.
Okay, so somebody brought up a good question. Who do you think would win in a fight, Jimmy or Moses?
But what, you see what I'm saying?
I think Moses, easy. Yeah. Moses, easy. He's a real thug. He's a real thug. Moses Jimmy's like a fake thug.
Fuck Moses. So fuck out of here, bro.
We ain't, we ain't even doing that shit. We ain't.
You're a fake thug, Jimmy. I saw a video of him like confirming he's really in the streets.
But shut the fuck
Books,
up.
Books is really in the streets, and he was laying down on the block.
Y'all ain't gonna try to skin dolly some bullshit up here, bro. You ain't doing that. You ain't gonna do that, bro. I should delete that motherfucker that put that comment up, bro. You ain't gonna even be able to.
Yeah, go ahead and bang your thin skinned little baby, thin skinned little white baby.
Nah, bro, hold up. I ain't get up on this motherfucker talking about fighting one of my homies and shit, bro. Fuck out of here. I told you it's two niggas that I want to fight for my real life, bro. I lost fights to both of their asses and shit. I want to see what my guy.
So you wouldn't go back and fight your rapists?
Bro, you a bitch. Shut the fuck up.
What do you mean? what makes me a bitch about that? You wouldn't go fight off your rapists?
All I'm going to say is I want to fight this nigga named Nick, and I want to fight Caleb. That's all I'm going to say.
Caleb? Those are two white boy names.
Hey, this Caleb motherfucker is some Suge Knight looking ass nigga.
Suge
Knight. You're telling me someone named Caleb looks like Suge Knight?
Yeah.
Caleb?
Yeah, Caleb.
That's a cracker ass white boy name, Jimmy.
Well, hold up. That's not no crack ass white boy.
And so is Nick.
That's some bro. Nick and Nick is a nigga.
This is proof that to this day your biggest enemies are white boys that bully you.
Bro, shut the fuck up. Wasn't nobody fucking bullied and shit, bro. I want to beat them niggas up. I lost a fight. That Nick
thought about just like moving on and letting it go.
I ain't gonna lie. I lost a fight to Nick like once in eighth grade and then again in ninth grade or whatever the fuck.
You guys look smart.
You lost boy.
Fuck out of here, bro. Hey, I'm delving into the goddamn history and shit, bro. Fuck out of here. I'm telling you, I'm not no nigga that's gonna be whipping everybody ass and shit. But
hey, CP Lord. Niggas, hey, what up,
them two niggas? I know I got it now, bro. Ain't nobody even playing.
Well, apparently, he's upset about his standard deviation again.
He's talking about fighting more people.
Yeah, I mean,
but now y'all did some bullshit. Like the people from my goddamn real life could potentially see this shit, and they might think that it's some
Jimmy,
bullshit.
You don't see people in
if
real
I
life.
If I ever see the motherfuckers in the chat, I'm like, bro, we could line that shit up. Real, I'm
Jimmy,
like,
you don't go outside. Hold up,
I'm 200. Hold up, I'm 200 pounds again, and I know how to goddamn fight.
You said you were 190 something. You said you were like 195. Now you said you're like 200 something.
I'm between 180 and 185 when I'm conditioned in my prime, like when I'm conditioned and ready to go. But I ain't conditioned right now.
Ready to go for what?
Ready to get in the mix. Shut up. Ready to get in the mix. Had a motherfucker.
So you're not ready to get in the mix right now.
I'm in a mix with the goddamn Miller and the weed and shit.
You always are. What else is new?
You're burnout. Your burnout at 25.
Goddamn burnout, bro. Fuck out of here.
So you wouldn't call yourself a burnout?
No, I'm not burnout.
He's in the prime of his life.
So Jimmy, you're not a burnout. You make enough money to be just at the poverty line. Dead end job. You're probably not going to move up in like the next 10 years. No other prospects. You're 5'3".
You see what I'm saying? Like you don't know
you
what
have no friends.
You don't know what motherfuckers got in the mix, bro. I think I want to do it.
Jimmy, if you had anything else in the mix, you wouldn't be doing what you're doing now. You're begging for attention online.
College, bro. That's what I want to do right now.
You want to go to college?
Yeah, Jimmy's going to college.
Why are you going now?
You're not getting paid.
What are you talking about?
So you're basically like an e-girl, except you're not getting paid or anything. You just come on.
How would you compare me to that goddamn e-girl, man? You know,
I mean, you're
because you get
now. Now we doing a
gang banged online.
College, man.
That's Jimmy, you
dude,
really
we haven't even had a fucking Jimmy day yet. You're just skipping steps.
Ain't nobody skipping no goddamn steps. But hold up. Y'all motherfuckers was talking about, y'all watched my graduation video, bro. Y'all know I got a goddamn scholarship.
Jimmy, you had a layaway cheeseburger yesterday.
But yeah, bro, because I thought that motherfuckers, you know, was, you know,
Jimmy, tight on the goddamn thing. You got to like, have to put a layaway on a cheeseburger. Oh, that's a new level.
If y'all motherfuckers want shows to, like, you know, go on and shit, y'all need to drop the Cash App and stuff, man. Motherfuckers got to get paid.
Why would we drop the Cash App? We can bully you for free. And we do.
Now, you ain't nobody bullying for free. Tyler just got banned. You know, he wanted to try to
do that. Dude. Hey.
You're thin skinned.
Yeah, I was about to say he has such thin skin.
Now, ain't nobody got
fucking
no
baby.
Skin. I'm gonna need them goddamn Cash Apps, bro.
Back to some Cash Apps to do
dude,
what?
All those White Claws must be over flooding your system with estrogen right now, dude.
All right, now hold up. That's the Cash App right there. Dollar sign the spaz lord. You know, yeah, in a couple minutes. And a couple
Jimmy,
minutes, we don't play tracks. You know,
just like in every other aspect of your life, what do you bring to the table that deserves anything?
Bro, I just told you motherfuckers about the two motherfuckers I lost a fight to. Hey, what's up, Carolyn?
Why would we pay you to reveal that you got beat up by two white boys?
Providing for our family and trying to do what's important.
There's mine.
What are y'all doing to make life better for yourselves? Yeah, but, hey, Carolyn, they ain't doing nothing. These motherfuckers up on this panel, they be playing. All goddamn day.
Well, I'm almost certain everyone in this panel makes more money than you and can maintain a relationship and doesn't pay $800 for a hooker.
Hold up. You don't know. Did I tell you what I be doing during the day? Y'all think I just drive a goddamn forklift and shit? Goddamn.
All right, tell me.
When them trucks got to get loaded, we got to use them goddamn little hand lifts and shit. Not them hand trucks, bro. The flatbed.
I know where they are. I've used them before, and I don't know. Is that like a flex?
Like, imagine having to fill a whole bunch of trucks because the other motherfuckers are like, oh, my back hurt. A whole nother dude. That's what I'm saying, bro. Motherfuckers is goddamn weak.
Well, maybe
weak.
If you weren't retarded and you furthered your education,
just like that motherfucker,
you would be doing something better.
My back hurts. My back.
Jimmy, you don't even have to lift anything. The fucking the hand lift does everything for you.
You gotta put it on Jimmy. You gotta put it on Jimmy and the other motherfucker. Fuck out of here.
Is this why you quit your last job? Because you just felt like, you know, everyone else was burdening you when really it's just you having to do your job.
No, bro, I'm saying like, bro, okay, so it's three of us. We all have the same job, but one dude don't got to do his goddamn job because he's talking about his goddamn back hurt. Fuck out of here.
Maybe his back does hurt.
Bro, I'm saying my back hurt too, bitch.
Well, Jimmy, I'm sorry you're being asked to do the bare minimum at your manual labor job that you have because you can't get any other job.
No, just like that motherfucker, you can't goddamn hang, bro. Like, bro, if you can't hang and you got a goddamn job doing a specific thing, you need to fucking quit. The one-armed dude, this motherfucker talking about his back hurt, y'all just quit, bitch.
Dude, the
one. Well, it seems like you're the one who can't hang because you're bitching about it.
Bitch, I've been hanging, bro. I've been hanging at the motherfucker getting my money. Fuck out of here.
Yeah, I know you're getting your poverty levels of money.
Fuck out of here, bro.
You can't just say fuck out of here.
That's that goddamn weak shit. You see what I'm saying? That's that weak shit. Y'all motherfuckers remind me of them same two dudes, man. One arm boy and my back hurts, motherfucker. Your ass.
Well, Jimmy,
quit. Get some motherfuckers up in this motherfucker that's gonna come to goddamn work and shit. This motherfucker been out for some goddamn days, bro. Came back talking about my back still hurts. Yeah, my back, my fucking back. I'm like, bro, you like 20, bro, you 22 or something years old. Why, how the fuck your back hurting like that, bitch?
Well, I mean, good for him because he's 22 at this job and you're 25 at this job. So, I mean, which is sadder?
Well, fuck out of here. I'm a strong motherfucker. Y'all talk all this other
Jimmy,
shit. I go to
you're
work.
You're not strong.
Goddamn day. But shut
you're
up.
You're not strong. You don't even have to lift. The pallet jack lifts for you and the forklift lifts for you.
Goddamn strong, bro. Fuck out of here, bro.
Dude, pallet jack and forklift are what you're lifting with. You're not actually doing shit.
Hold up. When you ain't using the goddamn forklift and you got to use that goddamn hand lift truck to load up them goddamn trucks, bro. Some of them got
hand lift truck.
That's fucking nothing.
Yeah, the hand lift truck. The hand lift truck. Like, it's like a.
You mean a pallet jack?
Yeah, you got to pump that mother. You got to pump that motherfucker in the goddamn truck. And if you
Jimmy,
do it wrong, all that shit going to fucking fall over, bro. And it's fucked up.
If you think pumping up a pallet jack is hard.
Hold up. You don't want them goddamn electronics and shit falling over, bro. Fuck out of here. Like, them goddamn shits, they weigh a lot, bro. And I be pushing them bitches, bro. I think it might be like, I ain't gonna try to lie and flex. So I think it's like 500 pounds that I be pushing, bro. Honestly, when I be doing that shit, bro, I just be thinking I'm doing kazushi in judo. Pushing and pulling the motherfucker. Like pushing and pulling. That's what I'm saying, bro. I'm just thinking about off balancing the motherfucker. It's just making my goddamn judo better, bro.
I don't know how you can compare like practicing judo to using a pallet jack.
But, it's kazushi. Because it's kazushi, motherfucker. Pushing and pulling.
Jimmy, you were just talking about how you're doing
pulling off balancing and shit, bro.
That's true.
Hold up. So you saying if I get when I get up in the ring and get in the mix and I put a motherfucker in that the head and arm throw, right? When I'm trying to get the head and arm throw, and I'm pushing that motherfucker just so I could get him like to fucking push forward a little bit, like offset his balance, and I'm gonna just switch up. I'm gonna switch up my goddamn stance and shit and use my hips to just throw that motherfucker forward because I want him to push forward. I'm breaking his balance. Fuck out of here.
You're pretending you're a pro again, but
been around that block, bro. I told y'all. You just watch videos I've been through this. I've been to the classes, bro. I know about
Jimmy. You just explained that you only did a bare bones foundations class.
But hold up, that's. You don't think that's all you need for in order to get in the ring and just mix it up on a motherfucker?
I don't think that's all you need. You took a 1 hour on the weekends class on the foundations.
Mix it up, bro. I started out with Taekwondo when I was a kid. I still remember the goddamn snap kick from that motherfucking Taekwondo class.
Oh my.
You know? Then I moved up to the boxing a little bit in the backyard. Motherfuckers doing a little bit of backyard MMA. Ain't gonna even lie.
Yeah, I went to
MMA class, bro. And they showed me how to goddamn mix it up. You know, my teacher was talking about the judo class that he went to. And I started going to free Sunday class over there, motherfucker. Let me tell y'all something. But look, I'm the motherfucker standing on top of the Jade Mountain. I'm standing on top of that Jade Mountain. You understand, bro? I'm gonna mix it up. I ain't even playing with you. I'm gonna mix it up.
You are really jaded.
No, bro, I'm saying
he's on the Jaded Mountain, is where he's at.
Nah, bro, y'all only know about one of the goddamn MMA classes that I fucking went to. Y'all don't know about the other goddamn what is it? Revolution. No, I ain't gonna even call the name.
Wait, did you get trained by Mr.
Well, now hold up. I guess I could call out this the other spot. I went to Revolution Dojo. I went to Mark Beecher's fucking kickboxing class and shit. And it was a couple other MMA spots I fucking went to, bro. That same goddamn year, y'all only got like just one aspect.
Why don't you just go to one? Why do you keep going to different ones? Do you get like exiled?
I want to mix it up. Like, y'all just saw how I was doing, jiu-jitsu and kickboxing at the fight lab, right?
Jimmy,
but I'm going to Revolution Dojo.
Let me tell you what I've seen, though. Let me tell you what I've seen from the video, Jimmy.
I'm saving my money to go to Revolution Dojo and just be doing judo a couple of days out the week, bro. I'm really just gonna start mixing it up, bro. Like y'all got it back to that point, bro. I just want to go. I want to go to Revolution Dojo just to learn how to throw
Chinese buffet food.
That's what we about to do,
Jimmy. I saw that video. The only thing that like you actually had any chance of doing anything to, and it looked like it was still winning, was that tree in your backyard. Like you were bouncing off that fucking thing every time you throw like one of those half-ass limp kicks or like slaps. Like, dude. It looks like you were swatting for flies.
Nah, fuck out of here, bro. Nah, that was a snap kick, bro.
It looked like it launched you back.
Hold up, that was impact training and shin training, bro. Because so why
were you wearing a whole, kick pad,
a whole lot of newbies. Now a whole lot of newbies. They scared of the goddamn dude. Impact. They don't know what the fuck. They don't want. They don't want. They goddamn. The, what is it? The end step of their foot or like that the flat part of the top of the foot or whatever the fuck to get fucked up when they kick. So they be scared. They be throwing out them little pussy ass kicks and shit. I went out and started kicking that goddamn tree. So I knew what happened when I fucking kicked a motherfucker, bro.
Dude. Muay Thai trainers even his backyard and people playing that train Minecraft, like that, punching they're trees not wearing and shit. Kick pads when they kick trees. You were wearing kick pads and you were holding back.
I'm saying, bro, like they be kicking banana trees. Banana trees are softer than that tree that I was kicking. Did you see how thick that motherfucker was?
Dude.
And now Muay Thai, hold up, Muay Thai dudes be kicking banana trees. Oh, man. Stop playing. That wasn't no goddamn banana tree.
Jimmy, you always talk about
that tree's wingspan, too.
Hey, hold up. Hey, what's going on, Bomb Cherry? What's up? Yeah, that was a whole regular ass. What was it, a maple tree or something? That was a regular tree. That wasn't no banana joint.
So you just like beat up on trees and you know yourself like proclaim Muay Thai
because he talks about how big it was afterwards.
And then he eats his after workout happy meal and plays with his toy.
Nah, fuck all, Jimmy. Hey, hold up, fuck all that. Fuck all that. But
Jimmy, you keep talking about.
Hey, do y'all know the difference between a roundhouse kick and like a snap kick?
Oh. Yeah, they're completely different.
They have two different names.
Nah, hold up. Do y'all know what a snap?
You know,
now where do you aim a snap kick?
Where do you aim a snap kick, Jimmy?
Probably the person.
You're supposed to aim that
like head. You know where you're somebody, looking. Hold up,
if somebody blocked that shit with their goddamn elbow, or whatever the fuck. You know, when you try to go to the body with like a snap kick, it's gonna fucking hurt you, bro, for real. But like a roundhouse kick, you swinging a goddamn baseball, you aiming to hit them with your shin, not the top of your foot. But you could kick somebody upside the head with like that top part of your foot, like the
Jimmy,
upside.
I would shotgun punch you in the fucking nuts.
Now you ain't shotgun punching shit, bro.
Jimmy, how do you differentiate a function?
Nah, bro, I'm differentiating the function. I know that I can only throw like a knockout snap kick off of my right leg, bro. So I'm gonna have to switch my goddamn. Bro, I'm not a regular southpaw, but I do southpaw when I'm grappling, bro. Like I like taking a southpaw stance because that's the side that I do my judo and shit off of, bro. That's the side that I'm doing all my goddamn throws off of, bro. That's the side I'm gonna fucking offset your goddamn balance. And I'm like, honestly, bro, I grapple like an old man, bro. Goddamn. I ain't gonna be out here trying to suplex niggas and shit. I grapple like an old man. I'm gonna trip your ass up. I went to basics, bro. Like, bro, when I was
and going that
to
was judo it, and
shit,
basics. Hold up.
When I was going to judo and stuff, bro, like all of them goddamn the sweeps and hip throws and shit. I grapple like an old man, bro. I'm telling you, I ain't suplexing nothing. Stand up, hold up. Like You fucking with Mistah Jimmy, aka Mr. Stand Up Grappler, bro. I'm a stand up grappler. Ain't nobody gonna do no flexing and shit, but I will stop your ass from goddamn stepping.
Then why do you buy a grappling dummy?
Hold on, wait. You said you'll fight anybody, but you said you're too afraid to fight Marty if Marty were to show up there. Which is it?
Let me tell you the story about. Let me tell you a story from judo class.
The story about the janitor.
Let me tell you a story from judo class, bro. It was this 300-pound motherfucker, big as hell. This motherfucker was a wrestler and stuff. Like I know motherfuckers who I can't do nothing to, bro. Sometimes you gotta admit defeat. Like I tried to roll around with that motherfucker. I just gotta admit I can't do nothing with Marty's fucking.
Pretty insane when the janitor 400-pound
ass, man. Goddamn.
So Jimmy, you've been talking a lot about like what you're gonna do in the future with money. Are you like expecting some big payout, maybe from a life insurance policy, possibly from your mother that you killed?
Now, ain't nobody expecting no big payout from no life insurance policy or whatever the fuck.
Just admit that you killed your mother.
and they're investigating
her death right now.
Stop playing with me, bro. Get out of here. We ain't doing that.
Well, then you shouldn't have killed your mom.
You are on my internet radio show, bro. You over here doing that?
You're offensive about it. Why don't you just like
Nah, bro. I'm saying he's on my internet radio show, man. Talking to me is a goddamn privilege. And like,
oh, the audience, the radio, two different things. It's like one or the other.
Audience has spoken for way too long. I think we got to do some tracks, some music tracks for the, you know, for the crowd, bro. I know y'all riding around H-Town, riding around y'all cities, getting y'all money, maybe just getting off of work and shit. Probably about to twist y'all one up, take y'all a little drink. So I'm gonna play something so y'all for y'all to vibe out to, man. All right. Then I'm gonna let the fucking callers and shit say more. Now we gonna play some of this Pet Shop Boys, man. We gonna play West End Girls. All right, you know, since we got like a mixed crowd right now, so let's get into it. All right, man. I know y'all driving around goddamn Los Santos and goddamn H-Town. Hopefully y'all.
Hey Google, volume 10.
What'd you say? But what is that? You try to get flagged? Come on, man.
Trying to catch me riding dirty.
Now he's trying to get my, he trying to get somebody flagged, man. Goddamn, stop playing that goddamn song. Yo, caller. You know, we open up the goddamn spot. Caller. All right. I guess that caller's gonna have to wait in the back because he doesn't have no no decorum, you know. So we open up the goddamn panel again. We dropped the link. I'm gonna be talking to the audience for a little bit. You know, and we might do a couple of spins, you know, if it don't go good, you know. So all right, what do y'all have to say?
So did you just go throw some more lye on your mom's body?
That first song was great. San Andreas was the best. Hold on, now they put whatchamacallit, West End Girls on GTA 5 too.
Do you get all your music from GTA?
Yeah, you see what I'm saying? Like that's why we gotta get the donations for this station. All right. You see what that dude just did? You know,
I did see it.
That was sick.
I can't explain that.
That was sick.
The internet's a mystery, Jimmy.
Hey, but hey, Los Santos and H-Town. That's the type of people you gotta expect. On this goddamn internet shit.
I was playing a song from H-Town. I was playing Riding by Chamillionaire. We played on ours.
You're trying to get motherfuckers flagged, but I'm the only motherfucker that's going to be taking the music
You're
break.
The one playing
comedy. I'm the radio host. I'm the H-Town radio host, man. That wasn't no. I'm the H-Town radio host. I was not no
Who right recorded that song? Who recorded that song that you just played?
That was Chameleon. Oh, hold up. That was whatchamacallit? Fuck. Pet Shop exactly. Boy. That was Pet Shop Boys.
Where are they from?
I don't fucking know.
Exactly.
Not from H-Town.
What kind of DJ is this?
And you say you're a radio host. Okay.
DJ doesn't know anything.
I knew the artist. Fuck out of here.
In the song.
You said H-Town Radio.
Yeah, but I'm saying that was a cool little track, you know, for all the motherfuckers riding around Los Santos and stuff. I think the people riding around Los Santos, they like pop music a little bit too, man. Fuck out of here.
DJ Delirium. The Miller Lite or whatever, and Weed High Times or something. I don't know.
What you got to say, New Jimmy?
I was just going to say it's like, I was hearing you talk about, like, I'm the radio host. Reminded me of, like, being in, you know, elementary school. I'm the line leader. No, I am.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, you know, like.
I'm king of the playground. Like,
fuck that.
You're not on a fucking radio show.
No, we doing a radio show right now, but we got tracks lined up.
It's like the new persona we're unlocking. We got tracks
lined up for the people riding around this motherfucker getting a Skrilla.
Would you say why you're cocks GTA? Lined up?
Like, but we ain't just got GTA tracks. Right? I played the Pet Shop Boys song because you know that was a cool little track. Not just because of the GTA. I heard it when I was driving around Los Santos.
Bingo.
He's losing touch with reality now.
Ain't nobody losing touch with reality.
It's called Little Pet Shop or something.
I was bumping it while I was riding around H Town getting my Skrilla.
Bumping Little Pet Shop songs.
Nah, fuck that.
Do you love GTA so much because you know you can't get raped there? It's kind of your safe space.
Hey, silly guy, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about, man, but I'm telling you, bro, hey, motherfuckers and you ain't like it. It was, I'm thinking about developing a GTA game. I want to put my brain as like a GTA character, you know. So, like, so when I speak on these stories, you know, they're stories.
One of these stories
that I want to pitch to the GTA motherfuckers, you know, the character was riding around this motherfucker, getting his Skrilla, running guns and shit, you know, making money on front.
All I'm hearing is he has a new delusion. I'm here for it. I'm here for it, Jimmy. I support you.
The gun thing.
Wait, you want to develop a GTA game?
No, we ain't got to develop.
How did that work out? You were saying you were a gun runner before. You
like maybe the side missions, you know?
What?
Or are you a gun runner? Like, what?
I didn't even hear what you said, man. I'm not fucking with you. Like, you want to develop a side quest or something? What?
Yeah.
You know how okay, much
I want to develop like a side quest. You know, maybe we could put a what you would call it, a dramatization. That's what I'm calling.
That seems like on brand, but you know how much GTA 6 costs?
Video game.
Yeah, somebody was telling me, oh, why would you get GTA 5 when GTA 6 is about to come out right around the corner? And shit.
You know, like, who else talks about being a game developer? Cyraxxx.
Yeah, you're right. Oh, now, God.
It didn't even got to be a GTA, like a side mission, but if they don't want it. Bro, do y'all know how easy it is to do a web series?
I'll save you the time. They don't want it.
Jimmy, do you know how many flunky retards they get giving them suggestions?
Now, fuck that. Bro, do you know how easy it is to do a fucking web series? You never
Why haven't you done it?
You never seen a war, man.
Spit for us. Freestyle. Give us something.
Now fuck that. We ain't nobody fucking freestyling.
Pitch your idea. Okay. This is a conference table.
If I was on OBS, I would be freestyling right now, but I can't do that till
I'm not talking about freestyle rap. I'm talking about like give us an idea.
I got one, all right. So I got this guy. We'll call him Jimothy. He got molested at 5 years old by a woman. He thought it was pretty cool, and you know, he screwed up pent up and like full of rage and stuff growing up. And he got into this fight in high school, and, you know, that's how he got blessed into a gang. No. And on his way out, the janitor had his way with him, too. So he's just taking...
Yeah, fuck out of here, bro. It ain't gonna be...
I have a pitch idea.
It ain't gonna be nothing like that, what that dude just fucking said. But it's gonna be like... GTA might as well take it, bro, because goddamn...
Yeah, in my game...
It's gonna seem like a movie with nothing like it to explain in it, bro. Goddamn.
Bring Bang back up. Mute
bring
him.
Bang back
you
up.
All right, this gonna be the concept, bro. Like, you ever played Bully? That video game Bully?
I have a better concept.
Nah, bro. It's basically gonna be like a.
I guarantee like, you have a better real, concept.
It's gonna be like a real hood movie. Like motherfuckers gonna be getting robbed.
Exactly.
The character, you know, he orchestrated a couple of, you know, robberies on motherfuckers. Y'all ever seen a motherfucker get tased? Like walked up behind and just tased on the neck, running them like get their pockets ran. Y'all ever seen some crazy?
That'd be a feature in the game. You get to run
now. Y'all ever seen some crazy shit like that?
Running guns and
all the goddamn money, all the goddamn acid tabs.
No, Jimmy, in your life of 25 years, what haven't you done? Honestly, I'm impressed.
Like, but in the movie,
it's been through it all.
Get tased upside the neck. Getting their fucking pockets slammed, money,
Bang's the only one here has to have experience.
It's gonna be Indian plugs, you know, getting set
Indian
up,
plugs.
Motherfuckers jumping inside inside that car, you know, pointing guns, taking goddamn ounces and shit. It's gonna be black motherfuckers, you know, so-called plugs getting, you know, ran up on in a goddamn minivan. Jack for a cell phone and ounces and shit, money.
So you're just gonna make Saints Row.
But it ain't no goddamn. I told you once, motherfuckers started explaining it. It might as well be some GTA shit. Y'all gonna think it's fake, man. Fuck out of here.
I mean, it is fake. So
Video games are fake. It's make believe.
It's gonna be motherfuckers.
Like it's entertainment.
It's
fun.
Hold on, thank you.
Now hold up. It's gonna be motherfuckers thank getting jumped in the goddamn park on that orange and blue. Getting put on the orange and blue.
Thank you to GG Allen for the 20. Appreciate it.
Little kids getting tased, right?
Hey, big time investing. Shut the fuck up. Ain't nobody did nothing like that.
I'm not big time investing.
You're running guns to little kids. I'm reading big time investing. That would be the game.
Jimmy shot guns to children.
Jimmy,
Jimmy, can you expand on that?
Nobody did none of that. Fuck that.
Can you expand on that then?
Expand on what?
Running guns to
on you selling a gun to a man so he could give it to his daughter.
Nah, ain't nobody said nothing, bro. I said that, but
Jimmy,
like that
you
dude,
said that. That was like that you made da-
oh, that dude's daughter
saying,
is older
I'm
than
a
me.
Gun runner. I got
that
SFL
dude's daughter
card.
Is hold up. That dude's daughter is older than me, bro. That's like a grown ass woman. I was trying. I heard
like
Marty
say
that on his channel last night, and I ain't gonna lie, bro. I did type in that chat room. That was a grown ass woman that I fucking sold that gun to. So fuck out of here.
Jimmy, that you said you sold it to
y'all,
a man.
Y'all be running. Y'all are some kids, bro. Like, y'all cannot handle information because y'all gonna run around this motherfucker slandering.
No, we can handle information.
That was a grown ass woman. That was a grown ass single woman living in a rough part of town. You see what I'm saying? I'm looking out for the goddamn community, bro.
Why is your mom tied to a chair in the living room?
I sold a gun to a grown ass single woman living in.
I can't hear shit. Everybody's just talking about like. Chill,
nah,
buddy, one person.
Yeah, I'm gonna throw him in the back, you know. Just
no,
in case
no,
saying,
no.
Just
mute
case,
him.
Just in case saying,
bring
hear
him
me
back on. You can mute him.
Yeah, but you want me to? I gotta put you in the back too, because like they be running around here. They trying to get me locked up. I sold a gun to a grown ass woman living in a fucked up part of town. I'm looking out for the community. I'm looking out for single women. You see what I'm saying? They want to talk about something. I'm misogynist and shit over here. So, I sold a grown ass woman a gun. So that
you
she can probably.
It's not that you're a misogynist. I just don't think you're
like.
Probably,
what do you call it? One of y'all, like, one of y'all crazy ass
middle-aged man to
give
to his young daughter.
You sold a gun to someone who lives in a violent neighborhood and is likely to use it to kill someone. That seems irresponsible.
That was a grown ass product. It was a legal gun sale. She passed a background check.
Well, yeah, you said she lived.
You see what I'm saying, bro? You see what the fuck I'm saying?
Like, I mean, if she passed the background check, why would she need to go do it again?
No, they ain't him. See, they ain't him, bro. I was trying to tell him. These motherfuckers ain't the first people that thought I was fucking capping about that story, bro. I am a legal. I sold my guns legal and shit. I did a background check on that woman, bro. I know how to do background checks and shit, man. When I did that little sale or whatever the fuck, I got the bill of sale and I did a background check on it, bro. I ain't gonna even get into all that other shit. Like, you see, they ain't never did that. These ain't gun runners. They were talking about, oh, he's Nicolas Cage from that such and such movie. Nah, fuck that.
Give me the one-on-one for a second. Hold on. You're not that. Nobody said you're that. I think you think you're Nicolas Cage. You make all these metaphors to movies.
Now, y'all nobody made a metaphor to a goddamn movie. Y'all compared me to that goddamn dude, but that like that little shit that I did. That little shit that I did, that was like, you know, that was just like, you know, it's me looking out for my goddamn neighbor and shit. Him hit me.
No,
up.
It wasn't.
Yeah, it was, bro. Like, that's what it was. It wasn't no Nicolas Cage. I'm running
nobody
guns.
Nobody said it was.
I'm running
then
guns.
Why do you
like,
call yourself gun runner?
Running guns like a fucking organization or some stupid ass shit. It wasn't none
selling
of that.
One
it was like looking
nobody
out for
nobody believes
neighbor.
That it was organized, Jimmy. We know you're too sloppy for that. You're just like Cyraxx.
Ain't nobody know too sloppy. Fuck out of here.
So how did you do the background check?
Bro, I'm not even going into that. You should know
why. Why? It's not like it's like a
I need the cash out, bro, because I feel like I'll be going too in depth. I think sometimes I'll be going too in depth.
That,
the op, so y'all gonna have to like donate for real. You know, you wanna know how I did it, you gotta donate.
Baby you haven't earned donations.
Yeah, hit the link.
Hold on.
The link.
Baby Ferrari gave me $10 to ask.
Donate what you can.
Why does he think he's a gun runner? He sold one gun.
No, you know what?
Thank you.
I'm not even going into that. If y'all want me to elaborate on that other shit, you know, it's a couple of other situations that I ain't gonna even say nothing about until you pay me. I need two
onions. Just gave me five.
Shut up. I need 200 because like that's like some. It's gonna be some backlash to that.
No.
What? The story about how you did a background check.
No, it's something else.
You use that little greasy trackpad on that computer that doesn't have Windows on it. So, like, what do you know that we don't? Nothing.
Now, what are you talking about? What do I know that y'all don't? So, what are you saying? Well, y'all hacked my computer?
A couple of weeks ago, I asked you to name two European leaders, heads of state, past or present, all time. There's a lot of European history. You couldn't do that, so...
You know what? Napoleon and
whatchamacallit? Whatchamacallit isn't one, Jimmy.
Nah, no, hold on.
Sylvester Stallone from out of Italy.
I'm not brushed up on European history.
Sylvester Stallone from Italy. There's one, Jimmy.
There you go. Sylvester Stallone didn't rule Italy. Fuck out of here.
I mean, yeah, he did. He's a stallion.
And then you have Sean Connery from Scotland.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, so like, I don't know.
Now, back to new Jimmy. You know, so what are you saying? Did y'all motherfuckers hack my computer, bro?
Yeah, no.
But y'all did. No. You just said you did.
I didn't say that. I said no.
Hey, said no.
Like, yeah, you did. Yeah, they did. Hey, what's up, Positive Contact? We're shaking, man. Yeah, hey, Louis Couture. That firearm sale was legit. You know, ain't nobody getting fucked over for that. I sold a legal gun, bro. I bought that bitch and I fucking sold it to a legal.
You sold an illegal gun.
Now shut up. I bought that bitch.
Yeah, as a Hoover Crip.
You said it.
Now, ain't nobody, bro. You going in the bag? Nobody said none of that shit.
So did you file the serial?
Now ain't nobody filed no serial number off of nothing, but that was a legal trade. Fuck out of here. And go try to do some stupid ass shit, bro. Like the dude got the bill of sale, bro. We already did that. Look, why you dipped off?
All right, so I'm gonna make an anonymous tip to the FBI just in case if they want to investigate that or not. I don't care,
Jimmy. Like, this is serious. Your mom has not been heard from for days.
Y'all ain't heard my mom on this motherfucker once. So what are you talking about? Some days? Fuck out of here.
I heard your mom a couple times.
That's a fucking lie.
You know it's not.
Yeah, I know it is.
Well, why are you so confident that no one's ever heard your mom?
Because she ain't never ran up on this motherfucker and did no SHP mama type of shit.
So you don't think anyone's even heard her make a noise? In her own home?
We all haven't.
Do you make her, like, walk on eggshells?
I think I heard her making some noise at one point.
That's a lot. You ain't heard my mama do shit. Now, ain't nobody got nobody walking on eggshells around.
I could have sworn I heard her getting fucked by her boyfriend.
Wow. Yeah, you know what? H-Town in Los Santos. You see what I'm saying? Look what that Randy dick sucker did. We definitely taking a break. Fuck out of here. Hey, Katie, be quiet. I talked to your mom, Jimmy. Fuck out of here. They say I don't be playing no H-Town. I got to play some H-Town right now. Los Santos and H-Town. All right, so we about to play some of this Pimp C, bro. I'm down for mine.
Foreign cars and foreign hoes. Foreign hoes. Come on, let's go. Yeah, man. Talking about my first solo album, bitch. I ain't never had one before. Yeah, they dropped that other shit while I was in the penitentiary. You know what I'm talking about? Got out and dropped that comp on their ass and fucked them up, you know what I'm saying? But hey man, you done slipped and slid to another lid, know what I'm talking about? Yeah, you know, this is a Pimp C starring in the naked soul of Sweet Jones. I'm glad for the past. I stay paid and I like blades. Old school cars and love and mace. Make a touch of toes. Make your girl lose her mind when I penetrate.
Los Santos in Houston. I guess I gotta play another track. I'm gonna need a Cash App, and you know, I'm gonna drop the link right there. You know, if anybody gotta jump up and say something, it's gonna be right there. But I'm gonna need a Cash App. You know the fucking God damn it! Come on, StreamYard. Don't make me go back to Stream Labs. Fuck out of here with that bullshit. I'm gonna need one of them Cash Apps from the ops. To talk to the ops or whatever the fuck, man. You know, they go to link. If any ops jump up on this motherfucker, you know, drop the Cash App so, you know, you could say your little, do your little thing. All right, you see it was borging out. I think we back up, though. I don't know which one will be next. We already did that one. Yeah, we do this one. Show. I just clicked it, bitch.
Headshot.
Frank.
Sit down.
Frank.
Stand up.
Frank.
Pass out.
Frank.
Wake up.
Frank.
Fade it.
Frank.
Fade it.
Frank.
Now I done grew around some people living their life in bottles. Granddaddy had the golden flask. Backstroke every day in Chicago. Some people like the way it feels. Some people wanna kill their sorrow. Some people wanna fit in with the popular. That was my problem. I was in a dark room, loud tunes, looking to make a vow soon that I'ma get fucked up.
filling up my cup, I see the crowd mood changing by the minute, and the record on repeat. Took a sip, then another sip, then somebody said to me, nigga, why you babysitting? Only two or three shots. I'ma show you how to turn it up a notch. First you get a swimming pool full of liquor, then you dive in it. Pool full of liquor, then you dive in it. I wave a few bottles, then I watch them all fly. All the girls wanna play, they watch. I got a swimming pool full of liquor, and they dive in it. Pool full of liquor, I'ma dive in it.
Pour, drink, headshot, drink, sit down, drink, stand up, drink, pass out, drink, wake up, drink, faded, drink, faded, drink,
drink. Okay, now open your mind up and listen to me, Kendrick. I'm in your conscience. If you do not hear me, then you will be history, Kendrick. I know that you're nauseous right now, and I'm hoping to lead you to victory, Kendrick.
If I take another one down, I'ma drown in some poison, abusing my.
Jimmy,
Yeah, you know what? I think, fuck it. I'm just go live again. Fuck all that.
Well, why didn't you try that in the first place?
I'm going to just do it right now. Just go live again. I'm about to end it. It's some bullshit. Fuck YouTube.